Working capital is one of those things you just need to know like the back of your hands if you want to work in corporate finance, whether you're building a financial model in investment banking or private equity, or about to invest in a company. To be honest, to even get into investment banking or any corporate finance job, you will be tested on the topic of working capital and the changes to working capital during your interviews. So, in this video, we are going to be covering everything you need to know about working capital, net working capital, and the right formula to calculate working capital. More importantly, we are going to be showing you why it's not as simple as just looking at the definition online, which is wrong, and why it matters so much in investment banking. I'm going to show you why everyone outside of investment banking has it wrong. So quick background before we get started. Working capital is the amount of money a company needs to operate on a day-to-day, week-to-week, and month-to-month basis. But it's not that simple. So why does everyone have it wrong? If you look up the definition of working capital online, anywhere, whether it's Wikipedia, Investopedia, Google, you will see the definition is usually current assets minus current liabilities. Now, this is a simple definition, technically correct, but it doesn't tell us anything more than just a number. This definition doesn't work because it's like me telling you the secret to a good life is not dying, obviously. But what kind of life should you have? What should you do? You need more information. Or the secret to a good meal is food. No shit, genius. But what food? What ingredients? What if you're allergic to something? You need more information than that. And that's what's wrong with the current definition of working capital. You need more information, and looking at it online isn't good enough. So when you go for your investment banking interviews and you get asked, tell me what is net working capital? And if you say it's just current assets minus current liabilities, that's not good enough. If you interviewed yourself, you'd probably reject yourself because there's a lot more to it than just that. And you need to know where the money is coming from, where it's going to, and how that's changing over time. In investment banking, when we look at working capital, we don't really care about the number itself. We care more about the changes which is happening in working capital, how that's changing over time. So let's take a look at our model for a second. And even if you did look at the number, let's just say we took a look at the typical definition. Remember, it's current assets minus current liabilities, which is supposed to tell you how much cash the business needs to operate, right? So let's take a look at this. What you see in front of you are the three financial statements, which I've gone through in previous videos. And where you can find your current assets and current liabilities is going to be within the balance sheet. And it's usually the first part for total current assets, which is right here. We have it listed as just over a million. And then below that, you have your current liabilities, which is listed as just 500,000. So the typical definition is current assets minus current liabilities. In this case, it's going to be around 500,000. And what this number is trying to tell you, if you just look at it from the typical definition perspective, is this company needs 500 million in order to operate on a day-to-day basis. If that's the case, then why would we include cash in it? Because if you go at the top right here in current assets, we have cash. So why would you want to include cash? Would this not be double counting? This is going to make it seem like you need more cash than what you actually do, and it's going to lower your valuation. Also, companies like Apple with huge amounts of cash on the balance sheet will distort working capital because it has a lot of cash which it doesn't need, but the typical formula isn't going to adjust for that. So how should we look at working capital? Essentially, this is how we should look at working capital in investment banking. When we are building financial models and providing advice or giving an opinion on the future value of a company, we care about working capital, what it would look like in 3 years' time, in 5 years' time, or how much money will it need to operate. Because imagine you're an investment banker and you're trying to sell your client's business. One of the biggest things a potential investor is worried about is, will this company they are about to buy going to eat up so much cash in the future that they will have to divert money from other operations just to keep this new business alive? In other words, is this business they are about to buy a ticking time bomb? Understanding working capital will tell you that. Because remember, the golden rule in financial valuation is cash flow. It's the end all and be all. And working capital is one of the steps you take from net income on the income statement to calculate your free cash flow. Remember what I said, we don't care about working capital itself, we care more about the changes in working capital, or what this is known as net working capital. And we have to be able to project this out in our financial model. To learn more about this, do take a look at our financial modeling course if you want to know more. So essentially, there are two ways this can happen. You can either have your current assets increasing faster than your current liabilities, or it can be vice versa. So in the first case, we have current assets growing faster than current liabilities, and in the second case, we have current liabilities growing faster than current assets. And the implication is the following. For current assets growing faster than current liabilities, this is a negative drain on cash flow, because here we are having to direct more cash into buying inventory or waiting longer to get cash from our suppliers, which creates cash flow problems. Again, no cash, no cash flow, no growing the business. Alternatively, you have current assets growing faster than current liabilities, which is positive for free cash flow, because it means that the company doesn't need to spend a lot of cash or direct free cash flow in order to buy up inventory upfront. Or their suppliers are really liquid and they're able to make payments really quickly instead of waiting 90 days to get paid. But you do have to be careful here. I have seen some companies trying to manipulate this number by delaying payments to their own suppliers. So it will temporarily make it seem like they have much better working capital than they actually do. This is technically legal, but you only notice these kind of things with experience. But again, that's something else. Whenever we look at evaluating a business or financial models, we are concerned with answering one question. Does this business need more cash to grow or not? Because this is going to dramatically affect the value of the business that someone's going to pay for it. So being able to understand working capital will make you better at financial modeling, or more accurate. So I hope this video has helped you better understand the concept of working capital, net working capital, and how to properly use it and understand it. If you are trying to break into investment banking, make sure to check out my video on how to ace your investment banking interviews, and also our guide, which covers over 400 interview questions and answers, which you'll need in order to ace your interviews. Until then, I'll see you in our next video. Don't forget to hit subscribe, and if you've enjoyed this video, please like and share.